sure you believe this. Part 3 is number 21 to 30. So let's get that started. Number 21 is Scary Terry from Rick and Morty.
At first, he's appeared to be bloodthirsty nightmare, but he is really just misunderstood. Scary Terry was very self-confident about how scary he was and feared that he may not be terrified enough to scare people, so he put a lot of pressure on himself because of that. This made him very tense and touchy until Rick and Morty entered his dreams and made him feel better.
Number 22 is Beelzebub from Futurama.
Beelzebub, commonly referred to as a robot devil, is one of the reigning intelligences in Futurama. He seems to resemble the devil of many Earth religions. He lives in robot hell along with many other sinmen. He is talented at playing the fiddle, therefore he owns the golden one. Possibly a reference to the song The Devil Went Down to Georgia. He lives in a New Jersey amusement park, apparently close to the salmonella produced by the Flume Ride. The funhouse located inside the park houses Robot Hell, accessible to the sun by pressing the symbol of Rokalology.
Number 23 is Mr. Burns from The Simpsons.
Burns' produced family is on Scottish descent, while the maternal family is of Scottish, German, and supposedly Mexican descent. His date of birth is arguable. He has been said to be born on September 15th, 1890, although he himself saying he was born in 1881. As a child, Burns lived happily in a northern state with his natural parents, Clifford and Daphne Burns, as the second youngest of 12 children. The youngest being George Burns and his teddy bear, Bobo. As a child, Burns was so cheery and admitted his parents called him happy.
Number 24, President Business.
Lord Business is an alter ego of President Business, an uptight company president who wants to organize everything around him. As Lord Business, he commands a robot ability who plans to take over the world by gluing together with this substance called Graggle, which is actually tube of crazy glue. Believe in imagination to be weird and messy in a world of order, he considers anyone with creativity in mind to be a threat, including Emmett, who, despite not having a creative bone in his body, possesses the cap to seal his defeat.
Number 25, Major Nixel from Mixels.
Major Nixel defies Mixels and he will do anything he can please his master. He is quick to anger, very easily. He treats the other Mixels like how the tornado treats cars, throwing and kicking them around and forcing them to steal Cupids. He might not be very smart. He has confused two Nixels from Mixels, not longer as he himself painted them to look like Mixels. He might just have a terrible memory, or he could possibly be old. Either way, he is disliked by practically every character, including his own minions. Despite his hatred for Mixels, Major Nixel can also be a little bit cowardly. When pressured, the Major is known to break down on the ground, almost in tears. He freaks out at the sight of his own leader and struggles to make things right when the king calls him out as a failure.
Number 26, Hector Conconet.
Hector Conconet was a memorable millionaire with a handsome and muscular, bulky body who tried to take over the world. However, When choosing the right mad scientist to build a doomsday machine for him, he happened to pick his disguised arch-enemy called Commando, who then blew him up. The other mad scientist he interviewed, Major Dr. Gasly, put their two remaining functioning organs, his brain and stomach, in containment capsules that are then later installed on the body of the purple circus bear named Oscar. While the brain of Hector is cruel and evil, the stomach is neutral and only cares about food, possessing a shrill voice. Both his brain and stomach is required to be containers with water to bring dehydration.
Number 27. Brain from Animaniacs and Pinky and the Brain.
The Brain is the intelligent maniac mouse that harbors a long-lasting desire to take over the world. He is often annoyed by his cage-made pink silliness, but it doesn't stop him acting on complicated schemes each night in order to achieve global domination. However, he notes that since he was really smart, that he could make the world a better place.
Number 28, Chef Bergen from Trolls.
Chef never wins the same as Trolls escape Bergen Town. She had it all, starting with pushing Thorns and Myers in a cover spot in a royal kitchen. In a way, she was happy, but everything she had built crumbled. The day the trolls blew blood in tunnels under the troll tree. This ended up getting the chef banished from Burger Town, causing him to vow to find the trolls and shove them down the ungrateful throat. After 20 years exile, his personality had changed for the worse, and she is now a power mad. Bergen, who plans to feed every Bergen a troll and become ruler of all Bergen Town.
Number 25. Number 29. Miles Finch from Elf.
The well-known best-selling Miles Finch arrives at Greenway Press Corporate headquarters in the Empire State Building in New York after agreeing to meet Walter and his team in an attempt to create a better idea for the children's book. During the board meeting, Buddy comes in and mistakes Miles and an elf, being extremely short, and asks him how to escape the North Pole. Unfortunately, Miles misunderstands and thought Buddy was insulting him. Miles goes on to brag about making more money than Buddy ever will, being extremely rich, and owning houses 78 plasma screen TVs in Los Angeles, Paris, and Belle. An effort to intimidate him.
Number 30, Toffee from Star vs. the Forces of Evil.
Toffee is a major antagonist of Star vs. the Force of Evil. He is a dirty monster that Moon fought when she was young. In Fortune Cookies, he infiltrates Ludo's army as a member of the Evil Avec League. Expert, when also removing, become the leader of the army around ripping the puzzle of looting and Marco grows a beard. After blowing up Cleveland Star's wand and storm the castle, he presents Ludo's body in a hard way with half of the wand's magic under his control.
Receive death.